everybody. Hey, Kendall. Good to see you all. All right, so we're going to jump in, and thanks, everybody, for joining. We're going to talk a little bit about your passion, purpose, and calling and how you can start taking action right now. You don't have to wait. Today's the day to get started. So thank you all for joining us. I'm going to tell you a couple of stories. And one is I'm going to tell you how I ended up here standing in southern Belize. This is next to a church in a Mayan village. And if you'd showed me this picture 5 years ago, I wouldn't have believed it. I would have said, how in the world would I end up there with those beautiful people doing a workshop and launching businesses with five different villages and working with churches and communities in the surrounding region? And I'm going to tell you how we ended up here. And every one of us has a unique story and unique journey. I grew up as a pastor's kid and was a youth pastor, and community and serving others was always top priority, and education was important. Long story short, I ended up moving to the other side of the United States and ended up doing my undergrad and master's degree at Harvard, and was selected to give the commencement speech. And that was a huge chapter close in my life. And then after that, I went to work in the US federal government and felt called to government and higher service, and still do to this day. So there's a picture of me in the bottom at the White House in the Roosevelt Room. To making this crazy jump, which we talk a lot about with Impact Junkie, is where you constantly are asking God, is this where I'm supposed to be, what I'm supposed to be doing, and making sure your passion, purpose, and calling are connected. And that's how I ended up on the back of an elephant crossing crocodile infested waters in Uzbekistan at their first ever innovation conference after the prime minister spoke, or roasting marshmallows deep in the rainforest with entrepreneurs and pastors we're working with, roasting marshmallows there in the bottom, and many other beautiful stories, from United Arab Emirates to Turkey to Guatemala to Belize, and working with governments and working with leaders in the country and working with individuals. All of these spaces I wouldn't have seen if I had just stayed in my comfortable space and just had my comfortable salary, my comfortable benefits, and just kind of settled in. And it's all leading to this. We heard a little bit about it earlier tonight, this Matthew 25 moment that we're all working towards. This is what it all comes down to. According to Matthew, these were the last stories Jesus shared before the crucifixion. And two of the stories, one is the parable of the talents, and the second is the parable of the sheep and the goats, which is not as much a parable as it is, he says, this is how it's going to go down at the end. I was hungry, I was thirsty, I was in need. What did you do for the things? You actually were doing it for me. And the other parable, we heard about the parable of the talents. And he said, I'm going to give you some things and I'm going to see what you did with what I gave you. When that's how this whole thing, that's what this all boils down to, this space-time continuum that we live in. And so are you getting ready for that Matthew 25 moment? That God robed himself in flesh, came, died for you, but that wasn't the end. Then he threw you the keys and said, I want you to take care of it until I get back. And then when he gets back, we are going to have that Matthew 25 moment. And he's going to say, what did you do with everything that I gave you? And that's what we live for. That's what we strive for every day. And this is a template that we help people start with on their Impact Junkie journey. It's an ongoing journey. It's a story that's never ending. It's continuing to get more. It's an adventure that's beautiful and exciting. And we start with this question, is I want to help blank to blank because blank. And we have a framework that you can join. I'll tell you how you can join. You can be a part of this to get started right now. You don't have to wait. To help figure out who you're meant to solve, who you're meant to help, what problems you're meant to solve based on the passion and the skills, the expertise, and the experiences that God's given you this on your beautiful journey. Every one of us has a unique story, and that helps you figure out your because or your why, right? And once you figure out that and you figure out who you're meant to serve and what you're supposed to do, you're never the same. You're on fire and you can start right now. So that's what we do. And I'm going to share that we're Impact Junkie. We say love people, go places, change lives. And this is part of the framework we help every Impact Junkie through, and understanding it starts with you and how to better love people, how to go in with empathy, how to go places, how to take action, actually go where people are, how to not just think about things or wish someone should do something, but how to actually turn that idea into action, and then how to change lives, how to scale it, how to connect dots, how to make it a real movement. Here's a quick film that will give you a taste of some of the things we're up to in Impact Junkie. Yeah. Talents and abilities, how we go forward.
This is your moment. This is where it happens. This is where your story changes. This is where you decide to take action. This is where you become the solution. This is where you see lives changed. This is where you are changed. This is where adventurous entrepreneurs go. Love people, go places, change lives. Let's get after it. The question you've got to ask yourself is, what am I meant to solve? What big, hairy, audacious problem are you meant to solve? In your city, in your community, in your country, in your world, what are you meant to solve? And once you answer that question, nothing can stop you. It's time to stop floating down the river of life, just taking whatever comes your way. It's time to live out the dream that's been placed inside of you all along. Start that thing, make that change, take that action, just go. There's just too much at stake and too many lives waiting for you to stay comfortable.
So all this footage that you've seen is from actual Impact Junkies going places, doing things, and it's opened up amazing partnerships and opportunities to work with the U.S. State Department, to work with governments around the world, and to work with Johns Hopkins University and Harvard University and other amazing organizations. But here's where we say, there's a lot of problems in this world, a lot of problems in search of a solution, and we don't have to look far to find some really big problems. Problems like 800 million people don't have access to clean water, or billions of people don't have access to clean sanitation, or millions live without shelter on the same planet, or billions don't have access to basic financial services or a bank account, and billions of people live without electricity. And in the United States alone, 120 people die from suicide every day. And 27 of those are active or retired military. So you don't have to look very far to find these big problems. And we've had to help some Impact Junkies kind of, when you first kind of faced with these, it can be overwhelming. And if you kind of have lived a certain way, you haven't had these experiences. We say there's three ways you can respond when you do come to grips with this. One is you can just get frustrated or spiral into deep depression, which we've had to help some through, and that's a reality. Second, you can just block it out and just kind of go on with your life, be in the bubble, be upset when Pumpkin Spice comes out in August and it should come out in October or whatever. Or three, you can do something about it. You can actually take action. And that's what we're all about, is you can actually be the solution. And in fact, the problems in the world are not really the problem. The problem is often us, because we need to step up to be the solution. and we could be the problem. So that's why we say, do more with what you've been given. Start something that changes lives. So, okay, great. You say, I love it. I'm ready. Sign me up. But where to begin, right? It can feel overwhelming. These are really big problems. I'm really busy. I've got a lot going on. It's not that I'm a bad person. I just don't know how to get started or where to begin. And in fact, there's a lot of material in this space. There's a book called Toxic Charity that I encourage you all to read. There's a line that says, when we do for those in need what they have the capacity to do for themselves, we could actually be disempowering them. And there's a film called Poverty Inc. There's a good friend that is the producer and director of that film. I encourage you all to watch as well. And When Helping Hurts, and there's others reading and materials you can find in this space. But basically it boils down to this phrase, you may have heard, give a man a fish or give a person a fish, you feed him for a day, show him how to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. We say that's great, but let's not stop there. Let's not just give them fish. Let's not just teach them to fish, but let's empower and invest in them. Help them buy the lake, start a fish hatchery, start a chain of fishing restaurants, sell fishing licenses to the community, influence national policy in their country, in their region, and build a professional entrepreneur training network to influence their country and spread across their region. That's what we talk, that's what we look for. And when it comes down to our personal life, it can feel overwhelming because sometimes impact or church is over on this side, and then my career or education and ventures is over here on this side of this wall, you know, and there's a wall dividing these two parts of my life and sort of compartmentalize. And we say, what if you could tear down that wall and not just say, well, I'll move a little bit closer, and all you do is you stay over here, you have a career just so you can make money and throw it back over the fence so other people can do the ministry, or so you can just sort of spend a little bit of your, you know, block out 10% of your life for ministry. But what if you could actually lower that wall and everything you do, every day you spend actually living out your purpose that you're called to do and living out the passion that God's placed inside of you. So a big part of what we believe on and the power of what the principles that align with what we believe is let's start impact ventures. Let's empower people to be the solution to their own problems. And in fact, we talk a lot about entrepreneurship and investment, but we say, let's redefine entrepreneurship back to what it's the root of what it's about is solving problems, finding needs and solving problems and being good stewards really of what God has given each and every one of us. And so we have an education side of Impact Junkie. If you want to join and be part of a cohort and work, get started right away, we'll tell you how you can do that. We have a production side. We do big events and investor conferences and films. If you're a creative person, this is a place for you to plug in, use your skills right away to start changing lives. And then we also have an investment side. If you're interested in investment or banking or any of that, finance, this is a place for you. Amazing projects that can have not only a financial return, but change lives on a massive scale. So there's a lot more to say, but we're just going quick tonight. If you look at this little pale blue dot, there's 7.7 billion people just waiting for you to step up. This is Earth. It's the farthest photo we have that was taken by one of the Voyager missions years ago. And that's it, that's Earth. Everyone who's ever lived, every experience on that little pale blue dot. And the idea is, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do next? How are you gonna take action and put a dent in this little pale blue dot? We say we're entrepreneurs and investors hooked on solving the biggest, hairiest, most audacious problems in the world. So Impact Junkie is not just an organization. Impact Junkies it's the Impact Junkies that make it what it is. So this is the question. You saw the film, what are you meant to solve? This is where every Impact Junkie starts on their journey. What are you meant to solve? So I'm going to share with you one more story just to give you an example. I'm going to pass it over to Zuri, who's going to share a bit from her experience as an Impact Junkie. If you travel down to Belize in Central America, it's on the Caribbean coast. And these are some of our friends in Southern Belize. And this is one of the villages and one of the church actually on the bottom right-hand corner. These are actual pastors and in the village there. And if you fly into Belize City, which is a very short flight, only a couple hours, from most places in the US. And then you drive down Hummingbird Highway and beyond till you maybe run out of road. You'll get into some dirt roads like this. You'll meet a family like this. This is Marcos and Elfinia, and their daughter. And they're actually pastors and essentially like the district superintendent in Southern Belize. They're Mayans, and they have a unique language and culture that's so beautiful. And we've learned so much from them. This was our first trip down. We actually went down to do a workshop. They reached out. We were working with the missionaries. They said, we actually have some amazing people that are saying, if you could invest, they want to start some businesses. And they would love to start some chicken farms because that's a skill they have. That's something that they can do to reach their community. And they want to scale that. Can you come work? So we came down. This is actually our first meeting in one of the sanctuaries there, you can see. And we started working with them. And Elfinia was there. We had five different entrepreneurs and pastors from across the region. And Elfinia stopped to make us lunch. This is her at the open flame with rice and beans and chicken. She made us this awesome meal. And we started noticing that they have these ancient Mayan weaving techniques. And we said, do you think you could do like an Impact Junkie X? We have the logo, and it's ingrained into the way we think and the way we attack problems and try to solve problems in the world. And she said, yeah, I think I can do that. So we came back the next morning, and this was her working on the very first prototype. And I snapped this photo in their kitchen as she was making the very first band. And we sent it out to all of our members and said, what do you guys think? Would you want to buy these? Would you want to use? Yeah, and they said, we love it. So we said, Elfinia, what do you think if we helped you turn this into a business? She said, I love it. And so this was their first sale. And 5 months later, we went back and look what we found. She had recruited women from the surrounding villages and the community, and there were Impact Junkie bands all over the place. And my favorite photo is Elfinia with a stack of cash and a really big smile as well. And then this is how I ended up here in Belize, and a group of us doing this workshop. You can see how it's grown. And we had Belizeans from across the region all there putting their dreams, what ventures they want to start. And you saw it begin to scale. And she got her cell phone through the business. We took them out. They got introduced into nachos. And later that night, we spent that night deep in the jungle. And here's a quick video to show a little bit of this story.
My dream is I want to do something, and I want to help my family by doing this business. We here in Belize City, have no job to do. It's good now because the Impact Junkie is helping me more. By doing my business, and I want to help my family. I want to do something with my children and to be somebody by doing this.
So that's just one beautiful story of many more stories, but it doesn't stop there. I don't have time to tell you all of the story, but we went back working with the US State Department. Marcos and Elfinia got up and told their story in front of the whole country. The assistant to the prime minister was there and said, Elfinia, we want you to come speak to all the women across our country and share your story. It's so powerful. And Marcos, later that night, we shared a hotel room and he couldn't stop. I kept saying, Marcos, we're so tired, we need to go to sleep. And he said, but I have another idea. What if we started this? And what if we connect?
Philip, your audio. Thank you.
We shared a hotel room and Marcos kept saying, I have another idea. And I said, Marcos, that's great. Let's talk about it Let's talk about it tomorrow. And he said, no, and I would try to go to sleep. And he was, I've got another idea. And then he said, you know what? You've changed the way we think. And I said, that's the most wonderful comment you could have ever said. Thank you so much. And so this is bigger than just their community. It's bigger than just their family, which it's impacting in a major way, where trying to afford even a one-way, they couldn't even afford a one-way bus ticket and would have to sell enough items to get another one-way bus ticket to go back to their village. Now they're influencing on a national level, and it even continues beyond that. This is a picture of us there at the event. The next day we drove back to their village, and they're on the phone with the credit union, the head of business development for the country, for the credit union, and they're launching a co-op with other farmers across the country. And the story is continuing to evolve. If you want to hear the rest of the story, you'll have to join us for one of our sessions. So here's the idea. Turn your idea into action. Don't just say someone else should, could, what if we did this, but actually turn it into action. So the question for you is, what are you going to do next? And if you're looking to connect your missions and your calling, and you're looking to start getting connected, even virtually with missions, or if you're interested in a job overseas to support missionaries, you want to get connected and you want to do it the right way, join us. You can go to impactjunkie.life/course and sign up for our very next cohort, and we'll guide you through the process. We'll do it together. But before we go there, I want to pass it over now. I warmed you all up for Zuri, who's one of the original Impact Junkies and has been on this journey, to share a bit of her story. I know we have some other IJs here on this session as well. Love seeing you all. But I want to pass it over to Zuri to share a little bit of her story and how she's put this into practice.
Good evening, everybody. Good to see some of your faces and your names. Because I am the person between you and probably your bed this evening, I'm definitely going to keep it a nice overview. Essentially, 3 years, about 3.5 years ago, if you had told me that I would potentially be using entrepreneur to describe who I am to a degree, I wouldn't believe it at all. When I went to college, growing up in church, I should start with that. I worked in every ministry, from children's ministry to campus ministry. And so there was this this fear that I would pursue my education and then not be able to find a space to utilize some of those gain skills inside of ministry. And so I remember graduating undergraduate and doing my graduate program in counseling and wanting to see and really praying about how purpose would begin to unfold in my life. And so I definitely think if you had to sum up my story, I would say that unknowingly God was working in my life and connecting me with the right people and the right experiences to drive me into my purpose. And so over the course of the 3 years that I've been working with Impact Junkie and been an Impact Junkie, using the framework of the loving people, going places and changing lives, I would say that I have definitely learned that through the word of God, we are commissioned as people of God to not only serve our communities with biblical understandings, but also to support their needs and understand those. And so I didn't really understand how I was going to do that. I had a counseling degree. And so empathy was a huge component of the degree, but it's not really, it wasn't really practiced for me until I started actually coming on some of these projects with Impact Junkie, being able to merge my love for travel, because I already had like a travel bug. I love to go around and see the world, but it was different having an opportunity to interact and experience people and really begin to understand the types of situations that they were trying to overcome in their own communities. And so with a passion for education, I am I play an administrative role at Johns Hopkins University. And I particularly aim to increase equity and inclusion within education. That's a lot of what my work is centered around. And so it's been a powerful opportunity to be able to sit with various missionaries and various programs abroad and domestic, and help talk about how to bring equity and change so that people have access to education that can hopefully empower their communities moving forward. And so as a true believer that hungry bellies don't have ears, I believe that making sure that I am also meeting the needs of people while also being a witness is really central. So I would say overall, I believe in the divine power of God and his ability to move things, but I also believe there's a personal responsibility that I have about what I do in my daily life and who I connect with. And so going places and changing lives is definitely an opportunity, or Impact Junkie particularly, has been an opportunity for me to really refine what my purpose looks like, because I don't think I would have been able to really verbalize it even 5 years ago. I just knew that I wanted to touch lives in some way that made a difference, in a way that they thought, a way that they empowered their own communities. So I guess, like we always say, I'm called to do what for what. And so through the work that I do with Hopkins as an advisor and administrator, I also do mentoring with youth from the various churches that I've been able to attend in the course of my moving around and going to school. So I've been part of a couple communities, and I've also been able to work with Impact Junkie as an advisor on various projects. And then also having my own passions of wanting to address different inequities in communities and underserved communities. And so through that, I just see myself walking in what God has designed for me to do, to connect with people and empower them to be change agents within their own communities. And that's my story.
Awesome. And Zuri, you also found yourself jumping off of a boat and in a lot of different places.
So fast forwarding after graduation, 8 years, I didn't think that I would be overcoming one of my biggest fears of drowning and actually taking the leap to scuba dive. I think that was probably the parallel moment where I understood what Philip really meant by leaning in. I felt like mostly like I was pushed in the situation, but I made it. But I think that whole experience was a significant, I was like, man, if I could scuba dive, then I could do anything. Like the courageousness, I feel like courageousness is contagious. So if you definitely surround yourself with doers, then you will hopefully build the courage to also continue to, overcome those, your personal fears. And I think a lot of our fears drive us to our purpose too. So I think that is also a huge player in my life. The things that I've been afraid of most, I'm also encouraged to help others overcome.
And I think there's many beautiful layers of your story, but being able to connect your background both as a Kenyan, half Kenyan, half Ugandan, to others who have a passion for that region. You've been able to help advise them and guide them, both your skills and your connections to Jamaica and the work that's happening there, and also your work in Guatemala and your connections with Johns Hopkins and your background to be able to work with the hospital there, as well as others in the rural villages. And it's just the way that you've been able to apply your background, your education, and your skill set in these really unique ways.
Yes, it's definitely a God thing, because in the process of those preparations, you never know what's going to come up. And so when you sit at tables and you're just like, I'm just going to listen. And then somebody asks something like, well, I might know something about that. Wait, I might know someone. So it's definitely blessings on blessings. And many of the blessings that I reap are from being connected to people who are also very much blessed and walking in their calling.
And I do just want to say one final shout out to Steve Drury, who's on the line as well. We call him the gold standard. and has had a heart. He and I connected on this, and he's had a heart for this from the very beginning. We said, what do you think of the name Impact Junkie? He said, I love it. So it's been a wild journey. Do you want to add anything here as we close out, Gold Standard?
No, I just wish I was about 40 years younger. Could I start all over again and run the races with you?
Well, you're doing it.
Just keep it up.
Awesome. So we're happy to stick around for any questions you all have or any ideas you want to talk about. But definitely, if you'd like, go to the link, impactjunkie.live/course, and join the next cohort. You're going to meet some amazing people. And it seems like we're traveling more virtually than even we were before, because we're able to go more places. It's actually a beautiful gift that God's given us. So, that's all we have. I know we didn't have enough time to get deep into everything, but if you have any questions, we're happy to help. Or if you want to email team@impactjunkie.co, send your questions there, and we're happy to answer them there as well.
Thank you for coming out.
Now we're going to start the coffee. Is this where we give out the prizes? All right. Thanks, Analia. Analia. Kendall?
Yes.
Hey, how are you?
Good. I'm doing well. How are you?
Awesome. I was telling Analia, she's a certified chef. I was telling her about the If You Love Me, You Eat project.
Oh, and yum. That is, yes.
Yeah. So Analia needs to get in on that.
Oh, for sure.
5 years as a certified chef, and she studied in France as a pastry. It's like specialized in pastries, which is very exciting.
Oh, wow. That is amazing.
Yeah.
My sisters tell me, they're like, I don't know why you went to business school. You totally should have just stuck with culinary.
Awesome. All right.
Great to see you guys.
It's good to see you. And Kendall, I saw your email. I love your email. We'll get back to you on that ASAP. That's like,
sounds good. Mind.
I love it. So I'll give a quick plug for another project we have going on. And Steve Drury already dropped off, but it's the UPTI Innovation Fellows. And it's another project we have going to connect people's talents and abilities to the kingdom and do a tour of duty inside headquarters of UPCI. So that's another hat and another life, but that's another really cool project that we just finished the first tour with the first Innovation Fellows, and we're getting ready to start the second tour and expand it. So it's growing, and there's an Innovation Council. So that's also another really cool thing that Kendall's been helping us with as well, which is awesome. All right. Well, we'll talk more. Email us. Good night, everybody, or good morning, wherever you are in the world. And look forward to living out the Great Commission.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Good night, guys.
Good night.